I've eaten many strange and scrumptious dishes in my time, like jellied gnats and dandy prats and earwigs cooked in slime. And mice and rice, they're really nice when roasted in their prime. But don't forget to sprinkle them with just a pinch of grime. I've eaten fresh mud burgers by the greatest cooks there are, and scrambled dregs and stink bugs' eggs and hornets stewed in tar, and pails of snails and lizards' tails and beetles by the jar. A beetle is improved with just a splash of vinegar. Yes, a beetle is improved with just a splash of vinegar. I often eat boiled slobbages. They're grand when served beside minced doodle bugs and curried slugs. And have you ever tried mosquitoes' toes and wampfish roes, most delicately fried? The only trouble is they disagree with my insides. I'm mad for crispy wasp stings on a piece of buttered toast, and pickled spines of porcupines, and then a gorgeous roast of dragon's flesh, well hung, not fresh. It costs a pound at most, and comes to you in barrels if you order it by post. It comes to you in barrels if you order it by post. I crave the tasty tentacles of octopi for tea. I like hot dogs, I love hot frogs, and surely you'll agree. A plate of soil with engine's oil, a super recipe. I hardly need to mention that it's practically for free. For dinner on my birthday, shall I tell you what I choose? Hot noodles made from poodles on a slice of garden hose, and a rather smelly jelly made of armadillo's toes. The jelly is delicious, but you have to hold your nose. Now comes the centipede declared the burden of my speech. These foods are rare beyond compare, some are right out of reach. But there's no doubt I'd go without a million plates of each. For one small mite, one tiny bite of this fantastic peach. For one small mite, one tiny bite of this fantastic peach.